Hello, in this one we're going to see what are lambdas in C++, and yeah, I'm going to just show you how to use them. Basically, what lambdas are just fancy name for anonymous function that you can create on the stack and pass around, and it's, yeah, it's much easier than the C way of creating just a regular function and passing a pointer to it around. And so, yeah, let's just dive into it. So here I have a little variable foo. By the way, I have a little script that auto-compiles my code whenever I save the file to help me out. And so I'm going to create a function f, which, I warn you, the syntax is horrendous for those, but bear with me. So first you create square brackets, then parentheses, then curly brace, like so, and in between the curly brace is your actual function's body. So here, let's say I want to return 32. And now you can just call f like a regular function. And let's say int x is equal to this, and then std println x is equal to something x this. Oh, reflex, I switched to the other one, but okay, yeah, x is equal to 32. So you see that it's an actual function, it executes it, and it returns what it should return. Unfortunately, there is also no, like, implicit return. You actually have to put the return statement, which is a bit sad, and makes them even more ugly, but, oh well, such is life. And so those functions between the parentheses, they can take just regular arguments, so let's say int y here, and here I can put, like, I don't know, 4, and let's say now I want y times 2, something like this. And so it now, yeah, executes the function, takes one argument. You can have y2, something like this. You can have any number of arguments you want. And yeah, just regular functions. So yeah, this is the main part of it. But now there is the square brackets, which I haven't talked about yet. And those are used to capture local variables that are currently in the scope. So for example, here I have a variable foo, and I would like to use my variable foo in my function. And so to achieve this, I can put foo between the square brackets, and now I can do foo plus, let's say y plus 2, because why not? And so now my function takes one argument. And you can see that it used 42 plus 4 times 2, which is 50, so that makes sense. Yeah, and so by default, the capture, if you just put the name of the value, will capture it by copy. So yeah, it will make a copy of it, which is not a big deal for like ints and so on, since they fit in a register. But if you have a large struct or a large object, you obviously want to avoid copies as much as possible. And so for that, you can prefix your value with ampersand to copy, to, well, not copy it, to capture it by reference. So this will just, yeah, be basically a pointer, okay? they say like aliases, references are just aliases and so on, but yeah, basically it will be a pointer, like, yeah, so that you don't copy stuff around. But yeah, and also if you have like multiple variables, let's say bar is equal to 24 and base is whatever, 25. And I would like to do foo plus bar plus base plus y, something like this. I would have to now, let's say I want to do by copy, I would now have to list them all, which is a bit annoying. So there is a shortcut called just equal. You can put like between square bracket just the regular equal, and then that will copy all the variables of the current scope inside of your lambda by copy. And you can also do the same shortcut with if you want to capture everything by reference, which is often a bit more useful. You can do just an ampersand between the square brackets, and now all your variables are copied by reference. Of course, here you can't really see the difference because they're all integers, but yeah. So yeah, that's the basics of lambdas. I guess I can show you how they're actually useful, because here I just show how they work. But like a very useful example would be, for example, if I have a vector of ints, and I want to transform is basically the equivalent of map. So you want to map a function on each element of a container. And this is the C++ version. So you give it iterators, this doesn't matter too much, and an output which will be the same. Let's put that on multiple lines. And so now you can pass it a function. And in C, you would have to have done like f, int, x, and then you declare your function, you return x times 2, something like this. Let's comment this out. And you would have to pass your thing as f, like so. Which, of course, like your actual logic is far away from your function, which is quite makes it a bit harder to read. And so in C++, of course, you can have lambdas. And so you could do like int x, like so, return x times 2. And now let's just print the thing. Boom, boom, boom. Let's remove that for. No, not that. And you can see now that it multiplied every element of the container by 2, as we expect. But we use the lambda, which is much easier to read. You can also, let's say, another little example. Let's use accumulate, which is, in other languages, it's generally called reduce or fold, but C++ has 1,000 variations of fold, reduce, and whatever. But let's just use that for now. So it takes a begin and an end to determine what's your container, then an initial element, what is called generally an accumulator, which is basically you will have one value into which you want to update on each element of your container. And let's say for now, I just want to do the sum. So again, I can use a lambda with two arguments and I can say ack plus x. X will be my accumulate is not a member of acc. Okay, I just imported did not include the correct header, which is a numeric for some reason. But so yeah, if I do this and I store the result like so, and I do this and print the result, it should be the sum of all of them, which is apparently 36. So yeah, you can clearly see of how it's very useful to have an anonymous function when you have like algorithms in your standard library, or yeah, how you can customize behavior with a little function from time to time in your code. So yeah, it's unfortunate that the syntax is quite bad, but yeah, lambdas are surprisingly powerful, especially the capture thing. So yeah, it's a trade-off, I guess. Anyway, that's all I have for today, and yeah, see you in the next one.